Yeah, so shall we start?
Yeah.
So how much experience you are having in total?
In total experience of 6.4 years.
Okay, that's great. So we will start with core Java first, and
Yeah.
then we will move towards the advanced technologies of Java. So can you tell me why Java is platform independent?
Platform independent. So it's basically because of the bytecode which runs in case of Java. So it is compile anywhere and run anywhere. So that is if you can basically Java code can run can be compiled on a Windows machine and then it can be executed on the Unix machine. So that's why it's platform independent of whatever operating system you use.
Okay, and why Java is not a pure object-oriented language?
Is not pure object-oriented language. There are primitive data types, I think, which are there in Java, due to which I think it's not the considered as a full-fledged object-oriented language.
Yes, you are correct. And so, what are the wrapper classes in Java?
Is integer, float, double, all these are the wrapper classes basically. So if you want to convert the integer or the primitive values into this object-oriented approach, so then in that case we go with the wrapper class.
Okay.
Basically, wrapper classes introduction as was done in Java 1.5, especially for this collection purpose. You got to use only objects, and the primitive data types are not accepted. So specifically for that, actually, to convert these primitive values into object form, these wrapper classes are introduced.
Okay. What is a singleton class? I mean, if I tell you to create, let me rephrase my question. So, if I tell you to create a singleton class, can you do that for me?
Yeah, singleton class I can create it for you. So singleton class is basically a class which returns only one object. We have to follow a few steps, and that is the constructor of the class should be private. And the object of that class should be initialized of a public method, a public static method.
Sorry,
So
your
since it's
voice is
static method
breaking.
class.
Your voice is breaking. So, can you turn off
Now am
your
I audible?
video?
Is
I
this audible?
think it will help us. You can turn off your
So
video.
yeah, I have turned off.
Okay. So, yeah, tell me.
Yeah, so a class can be made a singleton basically if we are declaring a private constructor in that, and we initialize the object inside the static method, public static method. So since the static method is belongs to the class, we can inside the static method we can create the object of that class, and we can access the static method outside the class with the help of the class name. So the object of that class will not be created, and with the help of the class name, we can access the static method. From the stat, then the static method is always going to return the only single object. So that's how we will achieve the singleton pattern or singleton. So the question was like with the help of clonable interface, how we can achieve it, right?
Yeah.
So basically, we have to implement the clonable interface and override the clone method. So in the clone method, we have to take care of we have to write the logic so that it returns only same hash value.
Is this clonable method, clonable interface is a functional interface?
Clonable interface is a functional. Yeah, it's a functional interface. got prefixing to the step.
Are you sure on that?
Yeah, closable interface is a functional interface.
So that means you can use lambda expression as well here.
Yeah, we can use lambda expression.
Okay.
Which with Java 8, yeah, we can use the lambda expression.
No. Clonable interface, I think it's a marker interface.
Yeah, clonable, serializable, yeah, these are marker interfaces, sorry.
Yeah, so that means it doesn't have that clone method. It doesn't have any method. And this...
It has the clone method, right?
No.
If we can override it,
no? No, clone method belongs to object class. Okay, no issues. We should move on.
Yeah.
So, can you tell me the difference between hash set and tree set?
So, hash set is basically the basic difference between them is in the hash set the insertion happens on based on the hash value, and tree set follows the default sorting order. So, the sorting happens in tree set. So. If any object is not implementing comparable interface, that cannot be basically used for in tree set. You have to customize it and make it implement the comparator class. Then only it can be used to insert into tree set.
Okay.
Yeah. In hash set, the insertion order purely depends on the hash value.
So, can we store duplicates or as well?
No, duplicates is not possible in set.
Okay. Okay. So, can you tell me difference between comparable and comparator?
Comparable interface basically gives you the natural sorting order. So, you got the two methods in one method in that is compare method, and in comparable interface you got the compare to method wherein it takes the two parameters objects object one and object two. This is the basic difference between comparable and comparator. With the help of in comparator we can make use of comparable interface as well and follow the sorting order. We can use the sorting order there. Basically, in case of tree set or tree map for the insertion purpose, suppose if an object is not implementing the comparable interface and we have to still insert that into the tree set. So in that case, we have to implement the comparable interface and insertion.
So, basically these both interface are used for the sorting technique.
Sorting,
but
sorting.
Yeah. So when you will prefer comparator over comparable?
Comparator. There is a comparison between the two objects. At a class level, we have to implement the comparator. We have to create an altogether different class where we have to write the logic for comparing in case of comparator. So basically, if it's possible for to start the if you say basically if the comparable interface is we are not able to achieve our logic with the help of comparator comparable interface, we have to go to the comparator interface and write our logic for comparison.
So where you will define the logic for comparison in comparator interface?
We can define the class and then there you can implement it basically.
Okay, so if you are using comparator, then there is no need to implement it. You can define the logic where suppose if you are using function interface and lambda expression, so there while creating object, not object of comparable comparator, but there you can define the logic also. Sorting logic you can define with while creating instance of comparator.
while creating with the help of lambda expressions we can do it.
So that is the main difference. So in comparable, you have to implement it in on the class level, and then you can use compare to method, and there you can define the logic. In the case of comparator, then you don't need to implement it on the class level.
And with the Java 8 aspects, I don't have the hands-on knowledge, so I'm not able to answer the questions on the Java 8 aspects. With normal Java 7 till Java 7, I have worked properly on it.
Okay, so Java 8, I think you need to read about Java 8 as well, because nowadays, nowadays Java 14 has come. So you should read the new technologies as well.
Yeah, I have given some time. I have done the some things, but the project currently which I'm working till my experience, I haven't got any exposure to use them in my in real time. So I have tried to understand the things from there. Like I have tried to understand the lambda expressions, and I'm trying to learn the stream APIs, how the things are working in there. But yeah, in the real life scenarios, I haven't got any chance to use them basically.
So have you practiced the stream API, the coding with stream API?
Yeah, I have tried to practicing the stream API. Somewhat ideas I have got, somewhat clarity I have about that.
Okay, so we will try that also. So that means you are comfortable till Java 7, right? So in Java 7, there was one features was introduced, that is try with resources. So what was that?
So try with resources is basically if you are implementing that, you don't have to it's with the condition basically. So if I will give you an example, if I'm opening a try block with the condition of connection, so I'm declaring a connection object in that. So basically the connection is started and the try block execution will be done. So you don't have to close the connection inside a finally block, or you have to explicitly close it. So try with resource will ensure that once this try block is executed, the connection gets closed.
Okay.
Basically with the condition, whatever condition you mention, that will get end after the connection, after the execution is done.
Okay. So can you please share your screen? We'll practice some of the coding.
Actually, I haven't got that system with me. I'm out of my that's why.
Sorry?
I don't have the Eclipse system. I don't have the Eclipse system with me.
No, we will do that on Notepad only.
Yeah, for sure. No problem. That is able to view my screen?
No, not now. Now I can see that. Now, yeah.
Yeah.
So I'm pasting something in chat box. So can you print the output for me? Write down it in your notepad.
So first will return true and the second will return. The first will return false and the second will return.
Okay. So can you write down a method or a program for me to check if the given string is palindrome or not? So do you understand what is palindrome?
Palindrome means the ABA, right?
So you have a given string like something like Nayan or any string.
Yeah.
So you have to check
yeah,
it
yeah.
if it is palindrome or not.
Yes.
Or else you can tell me the logic, what logic you will apply here, if you think.
So, I will do the comparison of the elements, like the first element and the last element.
Okay.
Likewise. Yeah. So that way, I mean, inside the loop, I will try to manage that. The comparison I will do, like the string array, string I will convert it to char array, and then the, with the help of that array, I will iterate the array and try to achieve this one.
Okay, so so how many times your loop will execute?
In this case, the loop will execute like this one, like see. N by 2 plus 1 times.
Okay.
Yeah, and then the length of the string divided by 2 plus 1. Because we will do the comparison of two elements inside.
Okay. So, we should move ahead. So, in stream, you have practiced for stream API. So you have a list of employees. So can you write a program in stream API to count the number of employees with age 25?
Stream API with, to count the number of employees with age 25.
Yeah. So you have a list, which that list has all the employees. And you need to write, you need to convert it into a stream, and then you need to find out the count number of employees with age 25.
There are the employee objects inside that, right?
Yeah. So you can start from as.stream. No need to write these things. You can start directly from as.stream or parallel stream, whatever you want to use. Do you know there is a parallel stream method also?
Yeah. As.stream.
Is that stream is an object?
Stream is an
Stream is an object or a method?
Stream is a method.
Okay. Yeah.
I think this way it will work. I think. Not sure. There's somehow like this way it will work. You know, we use a map or filter, and then we can be able to.
So, does this give me a list of employees which has age 25, or it will still? I mean, it will give me a stream, intermediate stream.
List we have to do, I think, with the help of which we can get the list at the end and be like this. We can give this to the list object. We can design a new list and then we can do it.
Okay.
Having Eclipse, otherwise I would have tried this.
So, what is n here in filter?
Oh, it's a lambda expression we have used here basically.
So n will be object of n will be object of employee, right?
Yeah, n will be object of employee. So.
So how can you compare employee object equals to 25 directly?
No. We'll have to sort it basically with the first we have to get the employee dot a number employee
no.
dot get age employee
n
dot
is,
get age and then
so n is an employee object, right?
Yeah,
so how can you compare write directly n equal equal
no no I'm not
25?
Considering it as a employee object, like we have to get the value inside I mean we have to use the getter method for the employee, where we get the age, and then that we have to pass basically.
Yeah, so you need to write down n lambda n dot get age equals equals to 25.
Dot get age, yeah.
No, not at the starting.
Yeah.
Okay. And no need to sort, because all the this stream will includes all the employees which has age 25. So if all are having same age, then no need to sort it. I mean, that doesn't make any difference. And after to list, I mean, you can't use directly to list. So there is a one more method you need to use, which is collect. And in collect, you can pass whatever type of collection you want to use to store these elements. So inside that, you need to write collector dot as list.
Yeah.
Okay. Okay. Yeah. So which you can stop sharing your screen, and we should move on the like advanced topic of Java. Like Java, like Spring Boot, and do you have working experience or Hibernate as well?
I don't have working experience basically on this topic. So,
okay.
Since I'm working on this legacy project, I don't have that much exposure on that.
So, do you have experience in threads?
No, I mean, in our application, it is used extensively, but we haven't got any chance for implementation of that.
Okay.
We just have to, just to know the methods, how we can implement and then start the project.
So what are the things, what are the technologies in advanced Java you think you have expertise on?
Spring MVC I have worked on.
Okay.
Then struts. And struts 2, struts 1.3 also, and EJBs, enterprise Java bins I am working on.
EJB you have used?
Yeah, EJBs I have used. So, few connections and EJBs we are actually working with our current project. It's a legacy application. That's the,
Yeah,
actually that
yeah.
is the primary reason behind which I'm looking for a change.
Yeah, so
Not having any
AJB,
experience.
like AJB and managed bean technologies are no longer in use. I mean, there are very few companies still using that, but we don't use that those nowadays. So you should also consider learning new technologies like Spring Boot and microservices. Have you are you do you know I mean, are you familiar with microservices?
Yeah, I mean, I've got some idea on that. Spring Boot, I have tried to learn from at my end. I've
Okay.
tried implementing some things with the Spring Boot. Microservices, I haven't implemented. I mean, I'm trying to learn them.
Okay. So coming back to like Spring MVC, you have experience, right?
Yeah.
So can you tell me what is dispatcher servlet in Spring MVC?
Is a front controller basically. The entry of that dispatcher servlet goes into the web.xml.
Okay.
That is the entire routing in the Spring MVC happens with the help of the dispatcher servlet.
Okay. And what is controller?
Controller, general controller class you are saying. So whenever our web server or normal JSP, if you are having a JSP page and there are parameters in that, when we speak the action button or the submit button, so the parameters and everything is going to the controller class, which is the main class which every routing and everything happens. So from the controller class, you go to the basic business layer, and from the business layer you fetch the data, you get it back to the controller class, and then that is been displayed again on the JSP. So entire routing in the MVC architecture happens to the controller class.
Okay. So what type of annotations have you used with Spring MVC till now? I mean, if you have knowledge also, you can tell.
With the help of XML, I have worked actually application context creating the application context object, and then in the proper application context or properties, we are mentioning the mapping, the
Okay.
bean mapping.
Okay. So can you
And
tell
then
me
it auto
what are the
and
different
annotation
types?
wise,
Yeah. So can you tell me what
annotation
are?
wise that.
Okay, no problem. If you haven't worked on annotation based, that is not an issue. So I'm coming to XML. If you worked with XML, then what are the different type of application context you can create?
Application context like class path XML context, then file path XML context. Then you have to, in case of web applications, we can also go for web app XML application context. These the classes can be implemented.
Okay.
Yeah. Annotation wise, I'm having some ideas on like you have to if you are using any class as a bean, then you have to give the annotation as @ bean. Then application @ application config annotation is also there.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay,
And
Tanmay.
@ auto where annotation is also
Okay, so I'm done from my side. Do you have any questions for me?
Nothing like any suggestions if you want to.
Yeah, so there are some things you need to work. Like from core Java perspective, there are many things. Like you need to understand many things. Like you haven't answered comparable and comparator, which is a very basic things nowadays because we are moving further. And apart from that, like you have to work on collections. What are the different collections? When you can use tree set? When to use hash set? There are many things like what is fail fast, what is fail safe, and
yeah, those things I have idea. Yeah.
Okay.
On those. Yeah. Sure. I will brush on
okay.
those concepts also.
Also,
and, learn these new things. Yeah.
Yeah. So you need to practice basic string manipulation programs, or like there are multiple ways to do that. There are many things available on the internet, and exception handling also you can try.
Yeah. I will try on this.
Apart from that, from my side, I would say you need to work on stream APIs.
Yeah.
Stream APIs is very important, because nowadays we don't write so much of lines of code. We use stream
yeah,
API
yeah,
and directly. We can do the
thing. Short with the stream API.
Yeah.
Yeah, sure. I will put my.
Sure. It was nice talking to you.
Yeah. Thank you so much.
Thank
Same
you.
Here.
Yeah.
And one more thing, I would like to just tell you. I mean, generally interviewers don't answer things when they ask the questions. But it was nice, like you explained me wherever I was wrong.
Okay.
Thanks for that.
Yeah, thank you so much for that.
Yeah.
Yeah. Bye bye.
Bye bye.